This segment of University of Hawaii Athletics Heart of the State is brought to you by The Cab. Call 422-2222. Welcome back to Hawaii Stars, University of Hawaii Athletics Heart of the State.
This football season brings a lot of changes to the Manoa campus. The Warriors will open play in a new conference, the Mountain West, and will do so under a new head football coach, Norm Chow.
I'm so excited for Coach Chow. He is a local boy who returned home after so many years to run the state's only collegiate football program. KHON2's Kanoa Lehi sat down with him to talk about year one of Chow time.
Norm Chow's average work day kicks off well before the sun comes up and usually doesn't end until long after it sets. So is the life of a head football coach.
How do you define the role of being a collegiate head coach?
I wish I knew. There's so many things involved with it, from ordering paper for the copy machine to making sure you put your arm around the guy that's having a tough day, to teaching them the techniques that we'd like to have. It's not work, though, Kanoa. I'm blessed. A lot of people would like to be doing it. We understand that. It's an exciting challenge every day. Every day is a different day. But the bottom, what brings you together is the young people that we work with.
Chow grew up in Palolo Valley, mere minutes away from the UH Manoa campus. The former Punahou and Utah offensive lineman first paced the sideline as a coach in 1970 at Wailua High School. Over the next 40 years, Chow would develop into an assistant coaching legend, serving as offensive coordinator at, to name a few, BYU, NC State, USC, and the Tennessee Titans of the NFL. But it wasn't until December of 2011, at the institution near which he was raised, that Chow was finally introduced as a college head coach for the first time.
You got choked up at your introductory press conference. Why? What were the emotions that are attached to something like this?
You know, I grew up here. 5 minutes from the school. I didn't go to school here, but I kept thinking about my dad. The son of some Chinese immigrants and who wanted so badly for his three sons to have some success with their lives, sacrificed so much. And that's what I kept thinking about. You know, he's passed away, obviously. My mother's still here with us. Just thinking about family and how proud he would be that we're back.
What does being the head coach at the University of Hawaii for the football program mean to you?
You know, for the longest time, I was so busy with my career that it didn't really, have much meaning. But after coming home and being around people that I know, that I grew up with, that, is of the same culture that we are, it's very humbling. It's very exciting, but I understand the responsibility that is ours, and it brings it back to reality that it is a very big responsibility, the one that we take very, very seriously.
We're here at the home field, Aloha Stadium. You've brought teams down here as a coach in the past. What do you recall about this place? What memories stand out for you?
Oh, there's tremendous memories, Kanoa. The excitement, the enthusiasm of the fans, how scary it was to come in and have to play these teams. It doesn't quite feel like home yet. This is the first time I've seen this stadium since we've been back. But it's home for us now, and it's awfully exciting. Our first goal is to get some of these students back into the stands where they belong as well.
How do you do that? How do you start to build the base of something that brings the students back, something that is that level of attraction for the public?
Well, I'm not sure I have all the answers. I think hard work. I think proving to the people and proving to the students that we will put a product on the field each week that they can, something that they can be proud of. What we would really like to see is our young guys just giving it everything they have, disciplined, tough, hard-nosed, that represents the culture from where we are, who we are, and then whatever happens, happens. The ball is oblong. It can bounce in funny ways.
Since his arrival in Manoa, Chow has preached the importance of, above all, commitment between team and community, as well as between coach and player. And this vow has been symbolized through a nondescript accessory.
And I asked him at that time for a commitment. We have to have a commitment that we're going to watch out for each other, we're going to care about each other, we have everybody's back protected. And once we had that commitment, I had them each come into my office, I handed them a wristband. It says, Amogram says the same things upside and down, and it's just to remind us that we're going to play hard and that we have a commitment to this program to be the best we can possibly be.
This team's best is certainly what will be required heading into a daunting schedule that features the likes of USC, BYU, and Boise State.
What kind of product are you hoping to see out on the field come season 10?
One that is tough, one that is hard-nosed, one that will play till the end, one that will survive and will stay tough throughout the game regardless of the score. Whatever happens in that first game, we all know who we're up against in that first game. It's just one game. If we're successful, we have to play the next week. If we're not successful, we still have to play the next week. So we need to sustain this discipline that we're talking about, this toughness that we're talking about. We have to sustain it through the course of the entire year.
Wow. Well, head coach Chow and the Warriors certainly have their work cut out for them, but we wish them the best this season. Go out and support the Warriors.
Go Warriors! When we return, we'll meet some of the individuals who are helping University of Hawaii Athletics get to the next level.